Okay, let's get started. Okay, welcome back everybody to Coffee and Art in the Morning. I'm Dee Dee, and now we're into we did some Happy Mail, we did some color improvements on a color book page, and now I'm going to continue working on a page that I started in the Curiosity Shop. I showed this in the other segment. I'm not going to flip through the whole book right now. I'm just going to go to the page that we're working on, which is some glass bottles, and I wanted to show y'all. So, all right, so this is as far as I've got. All I've done is a little bit of shading of blue behind it. I'm thinking this could be like a, like it's might be a skylight glass, like it's up against a window that's tilted. I don't know. You can make it, it could be a wall. I mean, it could be whatever you want, right? I imagined it in my color book world that it is like glass, like a slanted window right there. Oh, okay, little P. And so I just started coloring in some of the brushes and the cork. Somebody asked me about the corks. All that is two colors. It's like a tan color. No, that's gray. It's like a tan color and a brown. And that's all it is. I colored the whole cork tan, added a little bit of the sienna brown, and then went back and blended the tan to make. I wanted to keep. See, it's already got little lines in there. Look. See how it's already got lines on it to look like cork? So I just left it like that. So what I wanted to show you though was, and that's as far as I got, and coloring some of the brushes. I just use a sienna, a yellow, and a blue just to do different colors of brushes. And to decide that, all I did was get out one of my, or a couple of my brush jars and just look at the colors of my brushes. Some are blue, some are kind of a yellowy brown. So I just pulled out my brushes and looked at them. And so I just used three colors. You can use tons more. You can do, Okay, but what I wanted to show you is if these are glass bottles with reflections on them and you don't know what to do, a Google is your friend. So I just looked up some bottles. All I put in is bottle, glass, and light. And just the more specific you are, the more you'll be able to. Okay, so here's an example. So see how this is some blue glass. So just find you a color of glass. And look, there's all kinds of them. There's tons. Well, it's going to flash out on you guys, but I think you get the idea. Hang on, let me get my card back here to pull the light in. Come on. Come on. Okay. So I'm just going to look at some different colors. Okay, that's not coming back. Hang on. There we go. I'm just going to look at some different colors of glass. Like, I might start with a blue one, a turquoise. There's all colors, every color of glass. Amber, maybe just put an amber glass, green glass. So let's just do, say, let's do this one in green. And also remember, there's stuff inside. Okay, some of that stuff may or may not show through. Let me try to put in old medicine. Hang on. Vintage. Vintage medicine glass bottles. Oops. So you can just get ideas of how you want to shade them and color them. Okay, tons came up. Tons came up. Some are lighter, some are darker. There's a few clear ones. But remember, now, let's just say this is a clear one. Let's just say this is a pure glass one. I mean, not a colored glass, okay? The blue is going to show through that because it's clear. Same thing if I did this one or this one, the blue from the behind it is going to show through. Okay? So just remember that whatever's behind the glass is it's going to be showing through. It's a little trickier to do glass. But just follow the shade marks, Is helpful? Okay. All right, so, and I have no idea what's in these bottles. Some have pills, some have, I don't know what that is. Could be pills. I don't know. I'm just going to color them just to make it look cool. So, let's say this one then is a green glass. So I'm just going to kind of look for something that has kind of a similar green glass. It kind of looks like an olive green with lime green, kind of a lime green highlight. So let me, where's my sharpener? Where's my, hang on. Can't find my pencil sharpeners. What am I doing with them? There they are. So I'm just going to do a couple colors. I'm not going to get it complicated. Yeah, and milk glass is not, yeah, it's opaque. Exactly. So just look it up. Look it up. Google is your friend. Okay, so I'm just going to get an olive green and a light green. I'm just going to, I mean, oh yeah, these two. I'm just going to go with a couple of colors and just use them in blend and shade. Now, let's just say this powder in there is white. But even white might have a little tinge of blue to it or some kind of a little shadow. So I'm just going to go in there and just add just a touch of little blue. Not much. I mean, these have a lot of heavy dark lines too. All right, but you see how that's coming through? So you can see that line right there is coming through. All right, so I'm just going to go ahead and add some of the darker shadows on the glass where they have some lines. Okay. Just keep it light, guys. I'm going right over the pills or whatever's inside there. Lightly. I mean, just as long as you just keep it light, guys. Keep it very subtle and light. Just keep it light. If you have any questions, put it in caps. Just take your time and look at some references and see where the light would be coming through. All right. Down here, that's part of that bottle too. And now I'm just going to take the limer green and just kind of go over the whole thing. You don't have to make it too complicated. And then maybe like especially where that's coming through there, you might see a little bit more of the blue coming through. And that's it. Well, that would pretty much be it. Well, maybe just a little bit more shadow right along the seam. A little bit more green along the seam. There we go. And it's very subtle because it's transparent, right? And I just had already done this label. Yeah, and you can just go to, as much, oh, I forgot this part down here. You can color them as much as or as little as you want. As dark as glass as you want, as opaque as you want, as translucent as you want. It's totally, just look at a picture and decide how much you want to color it. Okay, now this brush right here, I did have some blue hairs on there. Get that a little darker. And maybe a couple of paintbrushes, we can kind of go back and forth. Let's go ahead and color a couple in a sienna color. Could have some silvery blue ferrules there. A couple of different, on the and maybe the brushes were had all colors of handles, but they were probably wood. I'm going to put some little blue highlights on the metal and then go in there with some light gray. And there's so much dark, it's almost like a little bit of grayscale going on in here. So I'm just going to go in here with a couple shades of brown. Take as much time or as little as you want. Get in there with some gray. A little bit of gray on the metal. And then probably go over that with white just to keep it nice and kind of shiny. Or you, if you have silver gel pens and you want it to be shiny, go with that. Go with that. You're the boss of your color book. Just kind of work all over the place. Easy peasy. I know, right? Let's get another shade of brown and maybe have a little kind of darker areas on some of the wood handles. Maybe right under the metal part might be a little darker. Maybe have a darker brown one there. Hey, New York Crafter. We're working in the Curiosity Shop color book right now. Maybe there might be a couple, maybe there's a couple of fancy ones, like a couple of nice green ones in there. Let's have maybe a green handle one. Maybe there's a little bit of, or maybe just a little bit of paint or something. Well, I don't know if it would be paint. I think they're using these brushes for doing something with the medicine, but now I can throw in a little bit of extra color somewhere because there's a bottle behind there. There's a bottle, maybe two, behind there. Thank you. Says, oh, you're welcome, Pam. That's sweet. Well, we're just here to share. I am anyway. You know, if anybody, if it, you know, helps anybody, I'm glad to do it. And of course, I love hanging out with you guys and talking with y'all. You know, that's fun for me. That's fun for me. And then that looks like kind of a pen there. Let's get in there with kind of another gray. That looks like a steel nib pen. So maybe I'll add a little bit of blue gray here and there. A little extra. Some of it's hard to tell what it is. But if you can't tell what it is, no matter if it's on a an inanimate object like this, or if it's in a garden or fruit or vegetables or whatever, you can't tell what it is. Color what you think it looks like. Who cares? Who cares if it's not what it, you know, if it looks like that to you, put it in. I can't tell if that's one, two, or three bottles back there. Well, if I don't know, I can color it all in black if I want. Don't get stressed out about it, you know? Golden syrup. I don't even know if that's a real thing. We could look it up. Vintage golden syrup. Or you can just color it anything you want. it just doesn't matter, guys. Don't, you know, just do however much detail and how much time you want to take. You can take a lot of time, a little time, you know, whatever time you got. But don't let that stop you from having some fun with the color book, for goodness sake. Maybe on some of these areas that are already black with the brush, I might go in there and just add a little darker black on those shadowed brushes back there. Kind of makes it pop. doesn't it? I honestly thought Dee Dee was working on a 3D art project. Yeah, not a coloring book. Yeah, it is. In case y'all just missed or just came in, it's the Curiosity Shop. I did do a flip through it in part one today in the Happy Mail segment. So, yeah, I'm pretty sure it was part one. But I did a complete flip through. And so, if you can't tell what something is, color it whatever color you want. Because you're the boss of your color block. Going a couple extra hairs in the brushes. A little darker. It's supposed to be fun and enjoyable and learning how to blend and shade and combine colors. You can't get stressed out about it because then it not only will it not be fun, you're not going to learn anything while you're too worried about what did the artist that drew that color book, was that supposed to be a horse hair, a squirrel hair, a sable hair? Golden's, yeah, I don't know if that's supposed to be it looks like it has a dead lion there. I'm guessing it's probably gold, like a kind of a yellow gold and yellow ochre label. That's what I'm going to go with anyway. So I'm going to get a yellow ochre, my sienna, and maybe just a little blue shadow. Some kind of a checkerboard. It looks like everything's sitting on a checkerboard table. So those checkerboards, I may want them a little darker. I may want those checks a little darker, and I may want the tablecloth. Maybe it's red checker. Maybe it's black and red check. Can be whatever you want. Whatever you want. Going to be an awesome page. Well, I'm not. I'm enjoying the process. I'm enjoying the process, guys. So I'm not gonna freak out about it. All right, so I think I'll just start with, let's do a wash. Let's do a wash. So I'm gonna take some yellow ochre, or let's go with butterscotch. Butterscotch has got a little bit more of a peach color too. I'm just gonna add just a tiny drop and get a brush here. We'll just start with a wash. All right, so I'm going to just get, and when you do a wash, you want water in the acrylic paint. And I'm just using golden acrylic paint, matte. It's matte, no shine to it, because if you have glossy paint, your the tooth is going to be shiny and you're not going to be able to go over it with color pencil. That shade got dark with the dead lion tongue. Okay, so now I'm just going to go over the whole thing. Very, just a wa very light paint in there. You don't want it opaque. You want to keep the, you want it transparent so you can still see. Still see the black lines in there. Okay, now let me take the heat gun, dry it, heat gun. Butterscotch pancakes. All right, now I think I'll just take a little bit of the, let me sharpen up my sienna here. And I'm gonna go like maybe just a little shadow around the words. Again, there's a lot of grayscale on this, guys, and this is probably a tin. It's probably some kind of a metal tin. You could add some blue in there if you want. Whatever. just if you're unsure, look it up. I'm not really worried about it right now. I'm just doing whatever I feel like doing it. Okay. Because all the words and everything are nice, you know, they're tiny. You can hardly see them. Now I'm going to go in here with my yellow ochre and blend behind those letters a little bit. And this is just how I'm doing it, guys. You do it however you want. You can go in there with your gel pens on top of the golden word. Remember, all this is vintage and old and rust, and could be whatever you want, or it could just be like you just walked into a vintage shop. All right, I'm gonna add a little bit of blue because maybe it is an old, you know, metal. Maybe it is a metal jar, or what do you call it? Tin. A tin. Yeah, that's could be a tin. So I'm gonna add some other colors on. Shadow under that lion. I mean, there's really no right or wrong way. I think you just need to keep adding things until you feel like it looks done. You know, I think we just sometimes think we stop too soon. All right, so maybe let's just say I wanted that light gold word to show up more. I could take, where's my Posca? Okay, and add some of the letters you don't even see back there. Just see bits of it, like it's going all around the corner. I'm just going to go over it. And if the white's too stark for you when you get done, then after the Posca or whatever you're using is dry, then go over it with the yellow, and it'll be, you've brought out the brightness. You know, by putting a coat of white on it, it will make it bright again. So you can go over it with a yellow or whatever if you want it. Or you can just leave it like that. Or you can do half of it. At what age did I realize I was artistic? I've been drawing all my life. I've drawn all my life. Mom's got pictures. Well, I think she still has some. I have some when I was quite young. Maybe there's a couple little swirls you want in there. You could do this with a gel pen too, guys. It doesn't have to be a Posca. Maybe those little white dots on the label stand out. Again, add as much or as little detail as you have time for. I'll just try to show you all different kinds of things we can do, but can't get much closer than that. It'll fade out. I mean, flash out. All right, let's just do a little bit more color down here, and then I'll call that one done. Call the little golden jar done. I'm going to hang that over your desk. Don't stop too soon. Yeah, there you go. Okay. This is like a big spool. No, it looks like another bottle lid. It's looking down on top of it. Looked like a spool right there. But I thought, no, it wouldn't be a spool. It's one of the bottles, like looking down from the top. It probably has one of those glass tops. Like this one has a glass top. This one has a glass top. I think that's just a glass stopper, a glass stopper. When she smelled crayons for the first time. Yeah, probably silver. Yeah, when I smelled crayons for the first time. Okay, so let's see. Let's work a little longer. Hope everybody's kind of getting some ideas. Let's work on one that's just like right there so you can see everything about it. Let's do him green too. All right, now there's a bottle here and looks like there's a bottle behind it. So let's go ahead and do an amber color bottle behind the green one. So I'm just going to take a little bit of sienna and just get the kind of brown amber bottle that's behind this one. So I'm just going to go in here wherever the lines are for shading. Just put some. It'll probably be a little darker too because it's behind this one. Now I'll take my yellow ochre and add just a little brightness to it. I'm just talking out loud, guys, what I'm thinking. Take it for what it is, I'm not thinking that, nobody's ever picked up a crayon or anything. All right, I want a little bit darker brown. And I just talk out what I'm thinking as I'm doing it. Your first toys were coloring books and crayons. Yeah, I don't remember. I don't remember what my first toys were. I have a picture of myself, well, at grandma's at Christmas, two years old, with some Christmas toys around me, pull toys and so. I mean, that's just like when you're two or one, but. All right, so that's the bottle that's behind the green one. I don't know. Mom might be able to tell me when I first picked up crayons. Of course, we all started with crayons, right? All right, now let me look real quick at my picture of the green bottle again. I'm going to do this one here green because we've got a green one there. I may have a green one here. Maybe one of these right here is green too. Maybe that one right there, or this one. Just kind of space them out so the colors are all over the place. So let's go ahead and I'm going to just take my lime green. I'm just going to, now of course the label, you can do those any color you want. I'm just going to go ahead and do the whole jar or the whole bottle a light green. And you can start with the lightest or the shadows. Because if you do it light, guys, if you have a light touch, you can layer and layer and layer. Okay. And then I'll take my olive green again and get in there and put some shadow, and then I'll go back over it. With the light green to kind of blend it out. Just do a little bit of swirly bits. I'm afraid to say your age because you still play crayons. Oh, don't be afraid to say your age and play crayons. Have you been here when we've bought? Okay, hang on. Have two boxes here. One, a box of 64 Crayolas or 96 Crayolas, not used. These are just for sniffing. Sniff. Take a sniff. These are just for sniffing. And if you travel, everybody needs a travel emergency crayon sniff box. Sister Woman made this for me. Everybody needs a traveling Crayola sniff box, emergency crayon sniff. You never know. You never know. You just might need an emergency crayon sniff. Okay. All right, so I'm just going to get some of these. See, there's lines and all kinds of little thing. Just follow it along if you don't know where to go. Again, because it's a kind of semi gray scale. It's not a grayscale to the point like show you the one Trina sent. Where is it? Where is it? Just had it out. What do I do with it? Well, I thought I left it out. The one Trina sent, the grayscale. I cleaned up too well. Well, I don't know what I do with my Trina. I know I pulled it out here. What did I do with it? I'm not sure what I did with my Trina page. Well, I'm not sure where I put it. I got so much mail going on right now. I don't know. Anyway, it's not a really true grayscale. Yeah, I like bookstores. I like to sniff books at bookstores or a new magazine. I'll be wafting through it. Just sniffing a magazine, leather journals. We all love sniff some leather. Okay, so now I go back over the whole thing with the lime green. Kind of blend. Because these green bottles are pretty bright. Kind of surprised how bright green they are. Okay, now go back in there with a little bit more. The grayscale line drawings are nicer on the heavier line. The heavier line pictures. Yeah, I guess it's just what you like, everybody. Hey, Dodie. Just depends on what you like, and it's all good. You practice on any of it. So if you're just joining us, we're just coloring in. Let me show you again. The Curiosity Shop. Chris Price. It's a square book and it opens, it flips up. It's like a calendar, it flips up. I'll back out here and again when we get closer to being done. All right, so maybe this label, let's see, maybe it's got maybe it's red. I don't know. Let's see. I'm gonna add, that's where I'm gonna add the most color is in the labels. And I'm not sure, how bright they might still be at this stage of, of the okay, this is something spirit. Whole bin. I bet that's probably some maybe some of these are art supplies. That's yeah, because look, medium. But golden syrup. Well, that was just probably a syrup that they use for the bottles. So these might not be medicines. They might just spirits. Maybe they're artist pigments. I bet that's what they are. Artist pigments. This one says artist on. See, I didn't even notice that till just now. I did not notice that said artist. So these aren't medicines. They're like pigments. Or mediums. Like this says medium on it. Alrighty then. Alrighty then. Let me make a little parchment-y color on that label. It's got some little lions on it too, or some griffins. A lion and a griffin. Probably, well, because, you know, he's in UK, so it's probably old vintage, vintage UK, British painting supplies. The green one is Albert Durer. Oh, okay. Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah, see, there you go. Some people are looking things up and looking at old labels. You get a little bit of education when you look up these old vintage things. Yeah, that's very cool. Thanks. Okay, I don't know if it's supposed to be red. I don't know, guys. I'm just coloring it the way I want. But feel free. Feel free to look up and color anything as exact as you want. Because you're the boss of your color book. Yes, we figured that out, New York crafter. I wasn't reading the labels when I first flipped through it, but now we see. All right, I want a little bit of blue in there just to give it a little shadow, a little age. Very cool. I love this book. Isn't it awesome, guys? If you missed the whole flip through, I did a full flip through earlier on the other first part when I showed the Happy Mail, I think was the part. Yes, I got that, Trina. Thank you. That's what I just said. That's a medium. Yeah. I know, guys. I know. Little snapping turtles, you guys. You are. You're little snapping turtles. all right, I'm just going to shade a little bit more around that label. Make it pop a little. Oh, my gosh, you girls. Okay, so let's see. Maybe now we are going to color these all. That's a Siberian white something. So maybe that's a white, you know, a powder. So that would be a good one to do white powder, but a pretty color bottle too. Of course, they probably have them in mostly clear bottles if they were pigments. Because they'd want you, you know, you want to be able to see the pigments in there, right? All right. So let's see. Let's do some orange. Let's go with orange. Let's do an orange powder on that one. Even though it says white, we're going to go with, well, let's go with an orange bottle. Let's just go with an orange bottle on that one. Or an orange tinted bottle. It could be still see-through. Okay, we'll go with an orange tinted bottle. Oh, we have fun. Okay. So, I think I'll just add a little bit of blue to the powder. Like, there's just a little bit of shadow in there, because if the powder was white, you'd still see some of the orange of the bottle. You'd see some shadow on there. There we go. Just leave a little bit of highlight. Okay, something like that. And then you probably see a little bit of the blue from the window there coming through. Let's do a different blue. Oh, let's do a brighter blue. You see some of this blue coming through from here, you know, reflecting through the bottle. So we'll put a little blue reflection in there. Snap, snap. That's right. Snap, snap. Okay. All right. And we'll go ahead and do just just a little bit of, keep this one kind of a white, but I'm going to make it like parchment. Let's get a nice tan color or a cream color, just so it's not pure white, you know. Peach color in there. I'm sure you can look up every one of these supplies and see the original bottles if you so desired. Sharpen my pencil. Thanks, Terry. It's fun. I just like to show the books and at least do a couple pages out of every book that we, you know, enable. I mean, color politely. All right, so just want a little bit of more. Just give it a little bit more depth there. Tim Holtz distressed inks would be great for those labels. Yeah, I guess if you could get in there with your Tim Holtz. Yeah. Get in there with your distress inks. You could. I'm sure some of you guys would, too. Get in there with your distress inks. I have a few colors. I guess I could get in there with a sponge or something. I don't know. We could try one. We could try to get in there with one. Let's see. Maybe a purple or a gray or something. Let's see. Guys, so we'll see. These are green. Mine are kind of old. We'll see if any of them still work. Let's just get a little, you know, like a little makeup wedge, because we'll have to be able. Oh, you know what? No, somebody sent me some of those little spongy things. Hang on, where did I put them? Just a minute. I want to bump the camera. Those little spongy things. You know what I mean, Vern? I don't even know what they're called. They're little sponges on a stick. And I just saw them yesterday. And I put them, I said, oh, I want to put this somewhere safe. Those little sponges on a stick. I want to put this somewhere safe where I don't forget where they are. And you know what? I forgot where I put them, didn't I? Hang on, guys. Let me keep digging for a minute. You know what I put them? I put it up here? No. Where did I put the little sponges on a stick? Just when you need something. Oh, my gosh. I really want to find that now. Did I put it in here? No. Just a minute, I'm not looking at chat, guys. I'm trying to find my little sponges on a stick. Otherwise, I'll just have to use little, the little daubers. I can't find it. But you know what I'm talking about. The little, they're little, little pencil-like things with a little sponge tip. So since I can't find that, I'm just going to have to use my little finger dauber. Ah. Wipe the ink onto the acrylic block and paint with it. Yeah, but I kind of wanted that smeary look. You know, I kind of wanted that smeary look. I can't find it. I don't know what I did with them. Oh, well, guys. It was a good idea. We'll do a couple of ways. Yeah, I got the acrylic block. We'll do it both ways. Hang on. I don't know where I put those daubers. I mean, those little foamy pencils. Well, this is like a little spouncer, but what it is, Jean, it looks like a pencil, but it's got a little, it's got like this on the tip. It's got the little, it's like this, you know, the little sponge tip. So, got acrylic block. Let's see if there's any clean space there. Let's just try it here. I was going to try a lavender one first. Let's see. Let's see if there's anything left in these old things. These things are old, guys. Let's see. Okay, I think some's coming off. All right, now if I just add a tiny bit of water, I don't know. I don't really want to water it down because then we're just using a, it might as well just be, watercolors then. You know? It might as well just be watercolor. I really wanted this one doesn't have much in it. A little bit. I wanted that smeary look. See? So I'm trying to do a lavender on this one. It's kind of a washed out lavender. Can you see it? Barely. It's not very dark. It could be that my, you know, it's not very much in there. We're testing. No, it's not a makeup sponge. Yeah, I mean, I guess I could find, I mean, I got the makeup wedges. I got makeup wedges. That's what I'd use for acrylic paint. But that's not what I'm looking for. It's a pencil with a sponge. It's like a, it's like tough like this. It's not real flexible. You know, it's made for art supplies. Oh, good grief. I know it's sitting here somewhere. Not, none of y'all are getting what I'm talking about, but I don't know where I put it. Let me think for a minute. I'm looking around thinking. I thought I put it in a pencil case, but I'm not finding it. Let me move some of this out of the way. I think I just got too much stuff. And I'm not finding it. Did I put it in my paintbrushes? Did I put it with the paintbrushes? That could be a possibility. No, not there. Oh, we're going to find it now. Now y'all got me on the hunt. It's not with my paintbrushes. At least not the ones I use. I wouldn't have put it too far away because I was thinking about how to use it. I was just thinking about how to use them, so I wouldn't have put them too far. Let's move these markers. Looking for a white pencil. Oh, I found it. I found them. Oh my gosh. Two different kinds. Actually, there's three different shapes. Okay. Oh yes, baby. Oh yes. I found them. There's two different kinds. There's the fantastic. These are the old version. Look, it's like a little spongy thing, okay? Then these are the new one. They're called brush sticks. And I forgot who sent these to me. But look at the different shapes. And they're like hard. It's not like a makeup brush. It's like hard. It's not plastic either. It's flexible. See? See? They're called brush sticks by Imagine. These. Yeah. Well, anyway, yeah, these are like the old version. And these I'd never seen before till somebody sent them. But, oh yes, now we're cooking. All right, so where's my purple again? Again, guys, I think there's just not much left in here. See? There's just not much left in here. I wonder, should I spritz this with some water or would that ruin it? You know, I'm not sure if I could add, can I add water to these? These are old guys, I'm telling you. I don't even know if I can get any much purple off of this one. Silicon tips. I don't know. It's kind of, they're kind of, what do you call it? Spongy. Again, guys, I picked the one color that's almost out, right? I mean, there's just nothing in there. All right, so we'll have to shade this one with some pencil or something. Let's go on to another color. Let's go in with a blue. Let's see if I got anything in these. Okay, so since there's hardly nothing on there. Ah! Oh, yeah, we're picking up some color now. All right, let's go with this little one here. There we go. See, now we're just stressing. Oh, yeah, we're going to try all different kind of things here. Don't know that it's much different, or for me anyway, it's not much different than using a color pencil, but we're going to test it out. Terry's already put in links. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, girls. All righty. So we're just stressing. I'm just kind of pulling it out there like that. I knew these were handy. It was just a matter of finding which tray they were in. Because I tell you, I was feeling like Jean looking for those white pencils. I think they can be refreshed with water and glycerin mix. Okay, I don't have any glycerin handy. I probably used to have some, but I don't have any now. They're just old guys. I'm telling you, these are. Ask Paula how old these are. They don't put dates on them because they don't want you to think they're. Oh, I take that back. This one does have a date, 2004. They don't put dates on anything anymore because I don't want you to think you're gonna, that it's old. But these are from 2004, so I'm just doing a light blendy here. Again, guys, I don't know that this is like any better for me anyway than using a color pencil. But it's kind of fun, it's fun. Just keep blending as dark as you want it to be. I'm just glad I found them because it was irritating me. And I couldn't find them. All right. Something like that. I don't know. What do y'all think? Is that enough? Could still keep it th see-through. Maybe there'll be one more. Maybe this one back here will be blue. So I'm going to pull out a few colors. We're going to go for it now. Let's do this one blue. Again, I have no idea what color, whatever pigment that could be in there. Could just leave it white. I know I'm going to go back in here with color pencil, but I'm going to at least give this a go. They're for painting or drawing in watercolor. And I think I lost some of y'all's. I lost some of the thoughts going through there. Okay, so just something like that. I'm glad we found them though. These are fun. I've never used these. I've used these before. You know, but I don't do a lot of blending, you know. I just, not anymore. I mean, you know, you do that in art classes and stuff like that. I just go right for it. Okay. There's some blue. All right, so let's go ahead and go from blue to, I really like that purple, but it's just, I don't have it. There's not enough in there. I don't know. Let's see what's this is aged mahogany. Let's do a little test with that. Let's see. Let's see if I have a little clean spot there. All right, I'm going to go ahead with the aged mahogany over some of the purple here. Because that purple's just not, you know, it ran out. What is the one you're using called, Dee Dee? It's just called Brush Stick by Imagine. I can't get any closer, guys. It's Imagine. It's just called Brush Stick. There's three different ones. I guess the three came in a set. Look, there's a round tip, a pointy tip, and a chisel tip. See? Welcome back with your lime green nails, Bonnie. I'm going to try to wash it off. I'm going to take a baby wipe to it here in a minute, and we'll see what happens to clean it off. But I'm just trying to distress, you know, have that distress look with the distressings because somebody mentioned it. So we have to try it out, don't we? We have to try it out. Right, Jean? And sassy pants. Okay. I'm not even doing the labels yet. Okay, this bottle would be, it would have some of the maroon colored bottle back there behind, between those two. What else could we use on it? Let's think of some other materials we can bust out. I don't like chalk, personally. I just don't like the feel of chalk. So, I don't really do much with chalk. So dry. That looks pretty good, though, for a distress ink, don't you think? And I don't do, I sent all my oil pastels to Vonnie because she is an amazing oil pastel artist. I'm telling y'all. If y'all have not seen Vonnie's work, bug her to see some. Okay. That looks good. Let's see what other colors we can rope out. I only pulled four, but I got a couple other ones over there. And I just keep rubber bands on and make sure the lids don't come loose because, you know, then you're really in trouble. And I know you can buy refills. And I just don't use them enough anymore, guys. I don't do any. Just don't use them, you know. Here's a green one. Let's try the green one. All right, I'm going to get a baby wipe and see about cleaning this off a little. Let's see what happens. Let's see what happens. Do they clean easy? Oh, look, it does clean off. It's coming right off. I don't know if it's just because it's the distress or if it's the baby wipe, but we got clean. Oh my gosh, that's working really well. Look at that, guys. Oh yeah. Now I probably need to dry it a little. I mean, you know, not have it wet. Okay, we're back in business. Let's see how much, if there's anything in this green. Yep, there's some. It's kind of an olivey green. All right, let's see which one do I want. I don't really want another big green one right there because I only have green, green, green. Let's just do one of the little ones right here. Or let's do this bottle, this green. Let's do this one. Let's do this one here in the front. Ooh, it's nice and olivey. It's quick. Tell you that, it's quick. Yeah, we're going to have to get Timmy in the color book industry next. I did have fun that one year doing his, I had to show those to y'all if I can remember where they were. I did his card challenge one year, his tag challenge, I'm sorry. I did his tag challenge one year where you tried to duplicate his tags, Christmas tags. I had none of his supplies, none. So I said, I'm gonna color, I'm gonna draw them. I'm gonna draw every tag. I drew all 12 tags in his 12 tags for of Christmas challenge, and he liked them, and he posted one on his blog, one of my tags. I don't know where I put those. Where are they? If I could find them, I'll show them to you. Oh, I think they might be up there on that top shelf. I'll pull those down after we're done here. I'll show you my 12 tags of Christmas. So that's pretty good. Look, guys, that's kind of cool. Let's just do a little streak in there. What do y'all think? Is that worth all the trouble of looking for them? All right. That's nice. It's a nice, it's a subtle green. What do y'all think? All right, let's go to another color. These are the color. I got some more colors over here. Let me go look. I got some amber colors. Let's see what other colors we got. Oh, I have another purple. It's not the same purple, it's lavender. Did I already have the fired brick out? I don't know. Okay, so let's try these. Tim Holtz is in the new coloring studio. Oh, he's in the new colors. Oh, okay. That's good to know. All right, here. Let's go with this purple. This is Dusty Concord. All right, let me just get a clean side here for a minute. Let's see if there's anything in there. Oh, thanks, Sarah. Oh, look. Oh, nice and juicy. Let's do a nice big purple one right here. All right, here we go, guys. Wait, what does it look? It doesn't look purple. What color is that? It says Dusty Concord. Looks kind of, well, maybe I just need to smear it. I would say it looks kind of gray. I guess that's why it's Dusty Concord. All right, we're just going to smear out some. We can go back in there with, color pencil too. But now I'm having a little bit of fun with this. Yeah, pay dirt. Exactly, Pam. Pay dirt. Good one, Pam. Good one. Okay, and there's some kind of stuff in there. Oh, that looks like might be some blue showing through from the back. Oh, wait, that's not the blue. Let me put a little blue. Same thing for this one here. I don't want to forget to put the reflection coming through, from the back, from behind. Okay, so I don't want to forget to put that in there. Okay, pay dirt. Pay dirt. Oh my gosh. Alrighty. Is that might be the table behind. I think that might be the table line behind it. Well, we're just going to go ahead and make it kind of purpley, I think, because I'm the boss of my color book. I can make it whatever I want. I hope I'm standing. I'm having to kind of really rub some off here, though, guys, because these are old. 2004. Oh, Paula. Paula's the only person I know that has supplies as old or older than me. Not my age. I mean, her supplies are as old. Yeah, you too, Bonnie. Like the old color book. I mean, colors sniffing. All right, so I'm just going to do a little bit of blend there. It is kind of fun, guys. It's not as you're it's a little less I don't want to say exact, but it's a little bit more just whatever happens, happens. You don't have as little, it's not as much control. You don't have as much control with the with these little distress ink thing here as you do with a pencil. And this is right off the edge here. We'll just have a little blend off there. Okay, let's get some. But it has been fun doing it. So I'm just going to kind of go real lightly over the whole thing so that you can see a little reflection. I mean, I'm just a little bit on the label too, just to bring a little of the purple in. But I'm really going to go over all the little whatever's inside these things. It says medium. It's chunks of something, though. It's like rocks in there. I guess you got to bust up that with some other... had the same ink as Didi bought in 2004. Yeah, well, I mean, can we really expect them to last that long? I mean, I've used them a good bit, guys. Don't get me wrong. I even have some of the old Nick Bantock ones. I have a whole bunch of these, too, that Ranger put out. The Nick Bantock ink. It's the exact same things. But Nick Bantock brand. I got a whole bunch of those. I can tell you those will probably really be dried out. I don't know though. They may not be. Okay. I'm getting a little over this now. I'm ready to move on to some pencil work. Okay, so I want this back here to be the blue, I think. Let me just get my, where's the blue? What blue was I using? Let me just go ahead and get some blue back here, because I'm not sure if that's on the table there. But, yeah, at least finish off that edge. I mean, because the bottle doesn't end. It's just it's supposed to fade off. You know, it doesn't have an edge. So let's just go ahead and go over there a little bit. Okay. The Secret Society of Crayon Sniffers. Is it really a secret? Okay, so now let's see. We're done with the purple. And I'm going to go in there with some color pencil too, guys. Seriously. But this is fun. It's fun. Let's see what other colors we have. I already did kind of a red color. Let's try the tea dye and the crushed corduroy, the brown colors. Let's see what we can do with each one of these. All right, first I'm going to take my baby wipe, though, and clean off the purple. That's neat that it just comes right off, right? The pencil work is clearly more vibrant. Yeah, yeah, it is. But, you know, this is fun, guys. It's fun to try things. Right? We're the boss of our color book. We can do whatever we want. Okay, that's pretty good. Let's test these out. Let's test the tea dye. And again, guys, I don't even know. Oh, there's a little bit in there. All right, let's do this one right here. You know what the tea dye would be good for? Is the labels. Let's add some tea dye to the labels, because that's like that, you know, really distressed brown look. So let's just go in here with our labels with the tea dye and at least get a... We'll go back in there with more color, but we'll get the background based in with the tea dye on the labels, because they're supposed to be vintagey. In my world, they're all vintage. All the labels are kind of vintagey. So we're going to put a little tea dye over all the labels real quick. I wanted to finish this page. We're already over an hour. We're not finishing, obviously. We got to play in. All right. Yeah, they're really, you know, I'm really having to work to get anything off of here, guys. If you buy these new, you're not going to have to do this much work to get them up. Let's see. Ooh, there we go. You're not going to have to do as much work to get them off of the pad. Just saying. So don't let that distract or detract from the ink pads. Let's see if we can just stress it up a little quicker there on this big one. Okay, there we go on that one. Let's do this one here. I just want to get the labels done, then we'll try a couple more colors. Are y'all still hanging with me? That's why I was talking about vintage labels. Okay. All right. There's one more. Let's go ahead and add a little bit on this one too while we're at it. Okay, I think we got all the labels covered. Okay, so now let's go ahead and try the brushed corduroy in a couple of areas. Yeah, this should be darker, so it should be, yeah. Okay, let's see how nice brown bottle here. We're making progress, guys, and I will back out completely here in a minute. Because now we're just going to town. Really amazing. Come on, guys. Oh, yeah. Yep, I'm still here, Terry. We're now into the distress inks. The distress ink pads with the little brush stick things. Yeah. But anyway, we tried some things, didn't we? That was fun. Get in here and again, you can go back in here with more pencil, which I will be doing. But I wanted to play with this since we talked about these things. All right, what else can we get in trouble with, Terry? All right. Let's go ahead and add a little bit to this. All right. Can you show a band talk book? Yes. I think I'm kind of done coloring for the day, so we can do a couple other things. Yes, I'll show some Nick Band talk book. Let me clean this little tip off again. It comes right off on the baby wipe. Look, I mean, it just cleans right off these little brush stick things. And it's, you know, they're like, I don't know, there's some kind of foamy stuff. I'm not sure. It's not rubbery. It's not rubbery like the like these things are. Let me show you. Like these, you know, these that you can use for clay and other things and wiping away paint. You know, these are good for wiping paint away, but they're real rubbery, right? These things. This one's not rubbery. It's foamy like. It's foamy. I won't repeat that, Terry. Okay, let me back up here, guys, and let's get a little organized. You can see the whole picture. Hang on. Pick up a little. Put some of these paints away and pencils. I'm leaving those out and one of these out because I guess I could clean that off too. Because then I wonder what happened to them. I don't need this rubber thing. I don't need the paint brushes. Hang on, guys. Let me get my brushes out of water now that we're done with them for now. All right, let me just do a little pickup. Acrylic blocks. Got so much stuff, guys, to pick up because I don't have a lot of room once it gets going. All right, let me back out so we can look at the whole thing again. Well, that might be too far. Let's go there. All right, let's focus. To focus. Come on. Okay. So, we Fantastic Griffin and Sabine series was a favorite of yours. Yes, I ate Julie Topaz. I'll show you all my Nick Van Tog books. Oh, but wait, I was going to show you my. Hang on, let me see if I can get up here on a chair. Let me hopefully not roll off on the floor. I'm going to stand up here and see if I can find my cards. I think if these aren't them, then we're going to go on to something else. I think they're in one of these. I think they're in one of these. My Tim cards, Tim Christmas cards. Okay, so if you're watching this is a Curiosity Shop coloring book. It's like a calendar. I'm going to do a quick flip real again because I did want to. Ew, I just licked my finger with the ink on it. I did a little more in-depth talking about each page on part one today. Here's what we've done so far with the glass jars, with the art supplies, and the paint brushes. This is what we've done so far. Again, guys, lots of color pencil work to be done. But we did pretty good for an hour. Just so you can take a little look-see. Again, lots of detail that you pass over by going this fast. So I talked about what was on each page. Okay, this is taking too long. I already went through the whole book, guys. I already went, let me go this way. There we go. Let's go this way. Let's flip. There's tons of pages. Different rooms with different things, different themes, I should say. Each shelf or each room or each window has a different theme to it. There's armory, weapons, geodes, watches and springs, dishes, bugs. So there are, how many pages are in this? How many pages are in here? Does it say? Now I want to know. It doesn't say how many pages. Let me flip, let me count real quick. Twelve, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 40. I think there's 40. I could be off, but I think it's 40. 40. Okay, so I think, guys, I'm going to go ahead and stop right here. If I'm going to show some Nick Bantock books, I want to show my I'll show my cards. I'll do another segment because we're already an hour and 15 minutes in. So I'm going to just stop on the Curiosity Shop, and then we'll do another little segment if y'all are up for it. Okay, so hang on, my chat kind of froze again. Okay, guys, 80 pages. No, there's not 80 pages. There's 40 pages. 40 pages. I just counted them, guys. I know I didn't miss 40 of them. I could have been off one or two, but I'm not off 40, Terry. Okay. All right, guys. Hang on. I'll